हेलो गाइस, दिस इज अदिब। वेलकम टू माय चैनल मूवमेंट साइंस, वेयर आई सिंपलीफाई बायोमैकेनिक्स विद जो। सो इफ यू आर न्यू टू दिस चैनल, कंसीडर सब्सक्राइबिंग। ऑल्सो चेक मी आउट ऑन इंस्टाग्राम, वेयर आई पोस्ट पिक्चर्स ऑफ माय नोट्स एंड द रेफरेंस टाइम फॉर ऑल द टॉपिक्स दैट आई एम गोइंग टू कवर विल बी मेंशन डाउन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन। सो चेक दैट आउट एंड लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। In this video, we are going to talk about the radiocarpal joint. Now, this will be divided into the proximal and the distal part. I've mentioned here proximal radiocarpal joint, but it's not exactly the joint. It's the articulating surface and the distal articulating surface. Okay, so we will be talking about that. And then we will be talking about all the structures over here, few angles, and we'll finish off the video. Next video will be about the ulnar variance, where the ulnar is positioned. Okay. So let's start with the topic. Now, coming to the proximal radiocarpal part, that is the articulating surface, it has the radius, it has the radio ulnar disc, also called as the TFCC, that is the triangular fibrocartilage complex, and that forms your proximal part. Whereas the distal part is formed by your scaphoid, lunate, triquetrum, and the pisiform bone. Now, let's have a look at this. If I take radius over here, right? And this is the ulna. Now, ulna is slightly below like this, and that we will be talking about in the next video, where we talk about the ulnar variance, where it is positioned. But this is how the articulating surface proximal will look like. Okay, so there is the lateral part of the radius that articulates, that is called as the lateral radial facet. Okay, then the blue part you can see over here, right? That is the medial radial facet. Okay, so if we take hand over here, the lateral part, okay, the lateral part will articulate with the scaphoid over here like this. Then the medial part will articulate with your lunate, okay, scaphoid over here, lateral part, medial with the lunate like this. And then the TFCC will articulate with your triquetrum and lunate. So this is your lunate and this is your triquetrum over here, okay. This one, scaphoid, lunate, triquetrum and pisiform. So lunate and triquetrum, that's where your TFCC will articulate. Okay, so it's something like this, your lateral part, then with the lunate, and this TFCC will go over here like this between these two. Okay, and then your ulna will be there below. So that's how the articulation occurs. And to add to this, the proximal part is biconcave in curvature and it is long and shallow. Okay, so if I remove this markings, you can see it is biconcave, correct? There is one concavity and the second one, you might not able to appreciate over here, but this is the first concave, the lateral and the medial part, that is concave, and it is shallow, it's not very deep. Now, the next part over here at the radius is there are angles formed by your radius. First is your average inclination of the radius, okay, which is around 23 degree. That is, if you can see, the radial lateral part is slightly higher compared to the medial part, right? And this inclination, if you see, is around 23 degree. So if you can see over here also, it's slightly inclined upwards. I hope you guys can appreciate it. And then the second one is the volar tilt, right? Volar tilt is of around 11 degrees. That is basically your radius is slightly angled downwards over here, as you can see. So those are the two angles that are seen at the radius. Now moving on to the distal part. Distal part, we already saw there is the scaphoid, correct? Scaphoid, then there is lunate over here, then triquetrum and pisiform, right? And pisiform, basically what is its function is it increases the moment arm for the flexor carpi ulnaris, okay? So there is the tendon of flexor carpi ulnaris which will go like this. And if you can see, if it was acting from a region where there is no pisiform, it would be difficult for the tendon to pull your bones, correct? But if pisiform is there, if it's going above pisiform, it acts like a pulley, correct? Pulley system, which increases its movement arm and gives a better edge to this tendon. Now about the surface over here. This surface is a biconvex surface, Okay, here you can't really appreciate, but I'll put a photo over here where you can see how it is biconvex, and this kind of changes its shape with the bones because these bones are very flexible. Now they are fixed with all the wires, but normally these bones are very flexible inside your wrist, so they change their shape now and then. Apart from that, what structures are there over here are basically there is the extensor carpi ulnaris tendon, okay, over here on the ulnar side, which is covered by a sheath, that is the extensor carpi ulnaris sheath. And then apart from that, there is structures like meniscus homolog. I'll talk about it in a while. And then there are other ligaments like your ulnolunate ligament. Ulnolunate meaning it will connect your ulna to your lunate, and then ulnotriquetral, again ulna to your triquetrum. And then there are also volar and dorsal radio ulna ligament, that is basically the ligaments which connect your radius and ulna, something like this. There is the dorsal and the volar radio ulna ligament, and between them lies your TFCC, that is somewhere over here like this, correct? So TFCC lies between your these volar and dorsal radio ulnar ligament. Going to the other structures, there is the extensor carpi ulnaris, the tendon, right? And this, it has a sheath around it, correct? That sheath is connected to the lamina of your TFCC that I just mentioned. And through the extensor carpi ulnaris sheath, there is also connection with the triquetrum, hamate, and the base of the fifth MCP. All these structures are connected to the TFCC lamina, correct? And this irregular connective tissue in this region over here, you can see a lot of ligaments, it is called as the meniscus homolog that I mentioned before. Apart from this, what we need to know is overall articular surface, it is very incongruent, and the contact that happens between your proximal and the distal joint surface is not more than 40%. It is somewhere around 20-40% of the contact that happens because of this irregularity. But that again helps us in getting the movement at the joint and makes the joint more complex. So that's all we have for this video. Now, to quickly summarize, what did we learn? We saw that ulna does not articulate over here, right? Directly does not articulate. Instead, there is the TFCC, and then a radius has two facets, right? The medial and the lateral facet, which articulate with your lunate and scaphoid respectively. Then we also saw the angles that are formed, the average inclination of the radius around 23 degree and the volar tilt of around 11 degrees. Then we moved on to the distal part where the bones like scaphoid, lunate, triquetrum, pisiform articulate, and the TFCC is connected to all the other ligaments, and this complex irregular connective tissue that is formed is called as the meniscus homolog, right? So with that, we finish off this topic. That's all for today, guys. Thank you for watching. If you like my content, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. It will really help me out. And thank you for watching.